The Medical Missionary Manual, Chapter 5, Where and How Medical Missionaries Should Receive Their Training, The Blueprint for Medical Missionary Schools. We have come to a time when every member should take hold of medical missionary work. We have come to a time when every member of the church should take hold of medical missionary work. The world is a lazar house filled with victims of both physical and spiritual disease. Everywhere, people are perishing for lack of a knowledge of the truths that have been committed to us. The members of the church are in need of an awakening that they may realize their responsibility to impart these truths. Counsels on Health, 425. God's people are to be genuine medical missionaries. They are to learn to minister to the needs of soul and body. They should know how to give the simple treatments that do so much to relieve pain and remove disease. They should be familiar with the principles of health reform, that they may show others how, by right habits of eating, drinking, and dressing, disease may be prevented and health regained. A demonstration of the value of the principles of health reform will do much toward removing prejudice against our evangelical work. The great physician, the originator of medical missionary work, will bless everyone who will go forward humbly and trustfully, seeking to impart the truth for this time. Welfare Ministry 127. Never forget that God is the only teacher and that He alone instructs. The great storehouse of truth is the Word of God, the written Word, the Book of Nature, and the Book of Experience in God's dealing with human life. Here are the treasures from which Christ's workers are to draw. In the search after truth, they are to depend upon God, not upon human intelligences. The great men whose wisdom is foolishness with God. Through His own appointed channels, the Lord will impart a knowledge of Himself to every seeker. If the follower of Christ will believe His word and practice it, there is no science in the natural world that he will not be able to grasp and appreciate. There is nothing but that which will furnish him means for imparting the truth to others. Christ's Object Lessons, 125. The common people are to take their place as workers, sharing the sorrows of their fellow men as the Savior shared the sorrows of humanity. They will by faith see him working with them. 7 Testimonies 272. God will take men who do not appear to be so richly endowed, who have not large self-confidence, and He will make the weak strong, because they trust in Him to do for them that which they cannot do for themselves. God will accept the wholehearted service and will Himself make up the deficiencies. The Lord has often chosen for His co-laborers men who have had opportunity to obtain but a limited school education. These men have applied their powers most diligently, and the Lord has rewarded their fidelity to His work, their industry, their thirst for knowledge. He has witnessed their tears and heard their prayers. As His blessing came to the captives in the courts of Babylon, so does He give wisdom and knowledge to His workers today. Men deficient in school education, lowly in social position, have, through the grace of Christ, sometimes been wonderfully successful in winning souls for Him. The secret of their success was their confidence in God. They learned daily of Him who is wonderful in counsel and mighty in power. Such workers are to be encouraged. The Lord brings them into connection with those of more marked ability to fill up the gaps that others leave. Ministry of Healing, 150 to 151. Speaking of the feeding of the 5,000, the providence of God had placed Jesus where He was, and He depended on His heavenly Father for for means to relieve the necessity. When we are brought into strait places, we are to depend on God. In every emergency, we are to seek help from Him who has infinite resources at His command. Ministry of Healing 48-49. If you are pressed close to the side of Christ, wearing His yoke, you will daily learn of Him how to carry messages of peace and comfort to the sorrowing and disappointed, the sad and brokenhearted. You can point the discouraged ones to the Word of God and take the sick to the Lord in prayer. Call Porter Ministry 41. Christ greets with hopeful assurance the very men and women who cause us discouragement. In them, He sees qualifications that will enable them to take a place in His vineyard. If they will constantly be learners, through His providence, He will make them men and women fitted to do a work that is not beyond their capabilities. Through the impartation of the Holy Spirit, He will give them power of utterance. Many of the barren, unworked fields must be entered by beginners. The brightness of the Savior's view of the world will inspire confidence in many workers who, if they begin in humility and put their hearts into the work, will be found to be the right men for the time and place. Christ sees all the misery and despair of the world, the sight of which would bow down some of our workers of large capabilities with a weight of discouragement so great that they would not know how even to begin the work of leading men and women to the first round of the ladder. Their precise methods are of little value. They would stand above the lower rounds of the ladder saying, "Come up where we are." He, Christ, corrects our erring piety, giving the burden of the work for the poor and needy in the rough places of the earth to men and women who have hearts that can feel for the ignorant and for those that are out of the way. The Lord teaches these workers how to meet those whom He wishes them to help. They will be encouraged as they see doors opening for them to enter places where they can do medical missionary work. Having little self-confidence, they give God all the glory. Their hands may be rough and unskilled, but their hearts are susceptible to pity. They are filled with an earnest desire to do something to relieve the woe so abundant, and Christ is present to help them. 7 Testimonies 271-272. Christ is the great teacher. 6 Testimonies 86, 152-153. 331. 9 Testimonies 170. Fundamentals of Christian Education 184, 224, 383, 450-451. The Greatest Educator, Desire of Ages, 809, 5 Testimonies, 588, Fundamentals of Christian Education, 48. Always remember that God is the great physician. The Lord would have the workers make special efforts to point the sick and suffering to the great physician who made the human body. The Lord would have His people come to Him for their power of healing. He will baptize them with His Holy Spirit and fit them for service that will make them a blessing in restoring the spiritual and physical health of those who need healing. 9 Testimonies 178. It is God who has made the provision that nature shall work to restore the exhausted powers. The power is of God. He is the great healer. Medical Ministry 11 and 12. We cannot heal. We cannot change the disease conditions of the body, but it is our part as medical missionaries, as workers together with God, to use the means that He has provided. Then we should pray that God will bless these agencies. We do believe in a God. We believe in a God who hears and answers prayer. He has said, "Ask, and ye shall receive. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you." Medical Ministry 13. Christ is the great healer. Ministry of Healing 22, 233, 244, Gospel Workers, 44, Councils on Health, 30, The Great Medical Missionary, Ministry of Healing, 267, 8 Testimonies, 201 to 202, 206, 9 Testimonies, 170. He desires to exercise his healing power through his obedient servants. Desire of Ages, 823 to 824, Councils on Health, 30, 9 Testimonies, 178. Enroll in one or more of the following medical missionary schools: the Word of God, the study of the Bible. There is very precious work to be done in connection with the interests of the sanitarium and school at Loma Linda, and this will be done when all work to that end. The Word of God is to be our lesson book, Medical Ministry 59. From the study of the Word of Life, students may come forth with minds expanded, elevated, ennobled, if they are, like Daniel, hearers and doers of the Word of God. They may advance as he did in all the branches of learning. Being pure-minded, they will become strong-minded. Every intellectual faculty will be quickened. They may so educate and discipline themselves that all within the sphere of their influence shall see what man can be and what he can do when connected with the God of wisdom and power. Ministry of Healing 466. The study of Jesus' life. Make the life of Christ your constant study, and labor as he did, following his example. Welfare Ministry 128. Do you, my brethren and sisters, inquire, what model shall we copy? I do not point you to great and good men, but to the world's Redeemer. If we would have the true missionary spirit, we must be imbued with the love of Christ. We must look to the author and finisher of our faith, study his character, cultivate his spirit of meekness and humility, and walk in his footsteps. 5 Testimonies, 385. The study of Jesus's medical wisdom. The book, Ministry of Healing, may do the same work for our sanitariums and health institutions that Christ's Object Lessons has done for our schools. This book contains the wisdom of the great physician. 9 Testimonies, 71. The home school. Many who desire to obtain knowledge in medical missionary lines have home duties that sometimes prevent them from meeting with others for study. These may learn much in their own homes in regard to the express will of God concerning these lines of missionary work, thus increasing their ability to help others. Fathers and mothers, obtain all the help you can from the study of our books and publications. Take time to read to your children from the health books, as well as from the books treating more particularly on religious subjects. Teach them the importance of caring for the body, the house they live in. Form a home reading circle in which every member of the family shall lay aside the busy cares of the day and unite in study. Fathers, mothers, brothers, sisters, take up this work heartily and see if the home church will not be greatly improved. Councils on Health, 427. From the first dawn of reason, the human mind should become intelligent in regard to the physical structure. Medical Ministry, 221. Parents should seek to interest their children in the study of physiology. There are but few among the youth who have any definite knowledge of the mysteries of life. The study of the wonderful human organism, the relation and dependence of its complicated parts, is one in which many parents take little interest. Councils on Health, 428. Let our people show that they have a living interest in medical missionary work. Let them prepare themselves for usefulness by studying the books that have been written for our instruction in these lines. Councils on Health, 426. Read the best authors on these subjects and obey religiously that which your reason tells you is truth. Councils on Health, 566. Learn to reflect as well as to study. that your minds may expand, strengthen, and develop. Councils on Health 405. There are many ways in which water can be applied to relieve pain and check disease. All should become intelligent in its use in simple home treatments. Mothers, especially, should know how to care for their families in both health and sickness. Ministry of Healing 237. Fathers and mothers, do you realize the importance of the responsibility resting upon you? Do you realize the necessity of guarding your children from careless, demoralizing habits? Allow your children to form only such associations as will have a right influence upon their characters. Do not allow them to be out in the evening unless you know where they are and what they are doing. Instruct them in the principles of moral purity. If you have neglected to teach them line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little and there a little, begin at once to do your duty. Take up your responsibilities and work for time and for eternity. Let not another day pass without confessing your neglect to your children. Tell them that you mean now to do your God-appointed work. Ask them to take hold with you in the reform. Make diligent efforts to redeem the past. As you faithfully do your duty in the home, the father as a priest of the household, the mother as a home missionary, you are multiplying agencies for doing good outside of the home. Councils on Health 429-430. The mother's work begins with the babe in her arms. I have often seen the little one throw itself and scream if its will was crossed in any way. This is the time to rebuke the evil spirit. The enemy will try to control the minds of our children, but shall we allow him to mold them according to his will? Fundamentals of Christian Education 150. There is work for mothers in helping their children to form correct habits and pure tastes. Educate the appetite. Teach the children to abhor stimulants. Bring your children up to have moral stamina to resist the evil that surrounds them. Teach them that they are not to be swayed by others, that they are not to yield to strong influences, but to influence others for good. Ministry of Healing 334-335. The demon of intemperance is of giant strength and is not easily conquered. But if parents begin the crusade against it at their own firesides, in their own families, in the principles they teach their children from very infancy, then they may have hope for success. It will pay you, mothers, to use the precious hours which are given you by God in forming the characters of your children and in teaching them to adhere strictly to the principles of temperance in eating and drinking. Fundamentals of Christian Education 143. The diet affects both physical and moral health. How carefully, then, should mothers study to supply the table with the most simple, healthful food, in order that the digestive organs may not be weakened, the nerves unbalanced, or the instruction which they give their children counteracted. Fundamentals of Christian Education 143. Do not neglect to teach your children how to cook. In so doing, you impart to them principles which they must have in their religious education. In giving your children lessons in physiology and teaching them how to cook with simplicity and yet with skill, you are laying the foundation for the most useful branches of education. Two Testimonies 537. Happy are the parents whose lives are a true reflection of the divine, so that the promises and commands of God awaken in the child gratitude and reverence. The parents whose tenderness and justice and long-suffering interpret to the child the love and justice and long-suffering of God, and who, by teaching the children to love and trust and obey them, are teaching him to love and trust and obey his Father in heaven. Ministry of Healing 375 to 376. Especially read 7 Testimonies 62 to 67, Counsels on Health 425 to 430, Child Guidance 339 to 470, Adventist Home 251 to 261, Ministry of Healing 349 to 408. Local Church Medical Missionary Schools. The medical missionary work should be a part of the work of every church in our land. Counsels on Health 514. Pastors and teachers are to work intelligently in their lines, instructing church members how to work in medical missionary lines. When the professed followers of Christ have an indwelling Savior, they will be found doing as Christ did. They will have no opportunity to rust through inaction. Welfare Ministry 123. To my ministering brethren, I would say, prosecute this work with tact and ability. Set to work the young men and the young women in our churches. Combine the medical missionary work with the proclamation of the third angel's message. Make regular, organized efforts to lift the churches out of the dead level into which they have fallen and have remained for years. Send into the church workers who will set the principles of health reform in their connection with the third angel's message before every family and individual. Encourage all to take a part in work for their fellow men, and see if the breath of life will not quickly return to these churches. Welfare Ministry 124. Every church should be a training school for Christian workers. Its members should be taught how to give Bible readings, how to conduct and teach Sabbath school classes, how best to help the poor and to care for the sick, how to work for the unconverted. There should be schools of health, cooking schools, and classes in various lines of Christian help work. There should not only be teaching, but actual work under experienced instructors. Let the teachers lead the way in working among the people, and others, uniting with them, will learn from their example. One example is worth more than many precepts. Ministry of Healing 149, Welfare Ministry 105 to 112. Medical missionary schools at camp meeting and other large gatherings. At our large gatherings, instruction should be given upon health and temperance. Seek to arouse the intellect and the conscience. Bring into service all the talent at command and follow up the work with publications upon the subject. Educate, educate, educate is the message that has been impressed upon me. Counsels on Health 449. At the camp meeting, instruction on health topics should be given to the people. At our meetings in Australia, lectures on health subjects were given daily, and a deep interest was aroused. Counsels on Health 467. On such occasions as our annual camp meetings, we must never lose sight of the opportunities afforded for teaching the believers how to do practical missionary work in the place where they may live. In many instances, it would be well to set apart certain men to carry the burden of different lines of educational work at these meetings. Let some help the people to learn how to give Bible readings and to conduct cottage meetings. Let others bear the burden of teaching the people how to practice the principles of health and temperance, and how to give treatments to the sick. Still others may labor in the interests of our periodical and book work. 9 Testimonies, 82 to 83. Evangelistic Effort, Training Schools. Early camp meetings were, in reality, evangelistic efforts. See Evangelism 21 footnote. They were moved from place to place and were largely attended by non-members. So the above quoted counsels would apply also to evangelistic effort training schools. Read Evangelism 107 to 110 for more on these classes. Country Sanitariums, Affiliated Medical Missionary Schools. The Lord has instructed me to warn those who in the future establish sanitariums in new places to begin their work in humility, consecrating their abilities to His service. The buildings erected are not to be large or expensive. Small local sanitariums are to be established in connection with our training schools. In these sanitariums, young men and young women of ability and consecration are to be gathered, those who will conduct themselves in the love and fear of God, those who, when prepared for graduation, will not feel that they know all that they need to know, but will diligently study and carefully practice the lessons given by Christ. The righteousness of Christ will go before such ones, and the glory of God will be their rearward. Councils on Health, 220. The Lord calls upon our young people to enter our schools and quickly fit themselves for service. In various places outside of cities, schools are to be established where our youth can receive an education that will prepare them to go forth to do evangelical work and medical missionary work. Councils on Health, 395. I am thankful when I think of the advantages enjoyed by the schools that are established near our sanitariums, so that the work of the two educational institutions can blend. The students in these schools, while gaining an education in the knowledge of present truth, can also learn how to be ministers of healing to those whom they go forth to serve. Councils on Health, 542. From our sanitariums, trained workers are to go forth into places where the truth has never been proclaimed and do missionary work for the Master. Medical Ministry, 323. Thus saith the Lord, buildings will give character to my work only when those who erect them follow my instructions in regard to the establishment of institutions. Had those who have managed and sustained the work in the past always been controlled by pure, unselfish principles, there never would have been the selfish gathering of a large share of my means into one or two places. Institutions would have been established in many localities. The seeds of truth, sown in many more fields, would have sprung up and borne fruit to my glory. I will raise up agents who will carry out my will to prepare a people to stand before me in the time of the end. In many places that before this ought to have been provided with sanitariums and schools, I will establish my institutions, and these institutions will become education centers for the training of workers. Councils on Health, 226 to 227. Schools outside the city. The righteousness of Christ will go before such ones, and the glory of God will be their rearward. Councils on Health, 220. The Lord calls upon our young people to enter our schools and quickly fit themselves for service. In various places, outside of cities, schools are to be established where our youth can receive an education that will prepare them to go forth to do evangelical work and medical missionary work. Councils on Health, 395. City Mission Training Schools. There should be connected with our missions training schools for those who are about to enter the field as laborers. They should feel that they must become as apprentices to learn the trade of laboring for the conversion of souls. Evangelism 107. In all our health institutions, it should be made a special feature of the work to give instruction in regard to the laws of health. The principles of health reform should be carefully and thoroughly set before all, both patients and helpers. Councils on Health, 452. While city missions must be established where call porters, Bible workers, and practical medical missionaries may be trained to reach certain classes, we must also have in our cities consecrated evangelists through whom a message is to be borne so decidedly as to startle the hearers. 9 Testimonies 137. Then begin your work in the school of experience. Let none pass by little opportunities to look for larger work. You might do successfully the small work, but fail utterly in attempting the larger work and fall into discouragement. It is by doing with your might what you find to do that you will develop aptitude for larger work. It is by slighting the daily opportunities, by neglecting the little things right at hand, that so many become fruitless and withered. Do not depend upon human aid. Look beyond human beings to the one appointed by God to bear our griefs, to carry our sorrows, and to supply our necessities. Taking God at His word, make a beginning wherever you find work to do, and move forward with unfaltering faith. It is faith in Christ's presence that gives strength and steadfastness. Work with unselfish interest, with painstaking effort, with persevering energy. In fields where the conditions are so objectionable and disheartening that many are unwilling to go to them, remarkable changes have been wrought by the efforts of self-sacrificing workers. Patiently and perseveringly they labored, not relying upon human power, but upon God, and His grace sustained them. The amount of good thus accomplished will never be known in this world, but blessed results will be seen in the great hereafter. Ministry of Healing, 153-154. All around us are doors open for service. We should become acquainted with our neighbors and seek to draw them to Christ. As we do this, He will approve and cooperate with us. Counsels on Health, 396. Before the true reformer, the medical missionary work will open many doors. No one need wait until called to some distant field before beginning to help others. Wherever you are, you can begin at once. Opportunities are within the reach of everyone. Take up the work for which you are held responsible, the work that should be done in your home and in your neighborhood. Wait not for others to urge you to action. In the fear of God, go forward without delay, bearing in mind your individual responsibility to Him who gave His life for you. Act as if you heard Christ calling upon you personally to do your utmost in His service. Look not to see who else is ready. If you are truly consecrated, God will, through your instrumentality, bring into the truth others whom He can use as channels to convey light to many that are groping in darkness. Counsels on Health, 425-426. The Macedonian cry is coming from every quarter. Shall men go to the regular lines to see whether they will be permitted to labor? Or shall they go out and work as best they can, depending on their own abilities and on the help of the Lord, beginning in a humble way and creating an interest in the truth in places which nothing has been done to give the warning message? Medical Ministry, 321. God calls for workers. The cause needs men who are self-made, who, placing themselves in the hands of the Lord as humble learners, have proved themselves workers together with Him. These are the men that are needed in the ministry and in the schoolwork. Let those who have shown themselves to be men move out and do what they can in the Master's service. Let them step into the ranks of workers and by patient, continuous effort prove their worth. It is in the water, not on the land, that we learn to swim. Seven Testimonies, 280-281. We are cautioned not to spend long years preparing for the work of God. There are among us many young men and women who, if inducements were held out, would naturally be inclined to take several years' course of study to fit themselves for service. But will it pay? Time is short. Workers for Christ are needed everywhere. There should be 100 earnest, faithful laborers in home and foreign mission fields, where now there is but one. The highways and byways are yet unworked. Urgent inducements should be held out to those who ought now to be engaged in work for the Master. 8 Testimonies 2:29. The youth should be encouraged to attend our training schools for Christian workers, which should become more and more like the schools of the prophets. These institutions have been established by the Lord, and if they are conducted in harmony with His purpose, the youth sent to them will quickly be prepared to engage in various lines of missionary work. Some will be trained to enter the field as missionary nurses, some as canvassers, and some as gospel ministers. 8 Testimonies 2:30. Young men and young women, gather a stock of knowledge. Do not wait until some human examination pronounces you competent to work, but go out into the highways and hedges and begin to work for God. Use wisely the knowledge you have. Exercise your ability with faithfulness, generously imparting the light that God gives you. Study how best to give to others peace and light and truth and the many other rich blessings of heaven. Constantly improve. Keep reaching higher and still higher. It is the ability to put to the tax the powers of mind and body, ever keeping eternal realities in view. That is of value now. Seek the Lord most earnestly that you may become more and more refined, more spiritually cultured. Then you will have the very best diploma anyone can have, the endorsement of God. 7 Testimonies 2:81. You need not go to the ends of the earth for wisdom, for God is near. It is not the capabilities you now possess or ever will have that will give you success. It is that which the Lord can do for you. We need to have far less confidence in what man can do and far more confidence in what God can do for every believing soul. He longs to have you reach after him by faith. He longs to have you expect great things from him. He longs to give you understanding in temporal as well as in spiritual matters. He can sharpen the intellect. He can give tact and skill. Put your talents into the work. Ask God for wisdom, and it will be given you. Christ Object Lessons 146. This work requires self-sacrifice. While many are waiting to have every obstacle removed, the work they might do is left undone, and multitudes are dying without hope and without God. Ministry of Healing 156. The practice of furnishing a few persons with every advantage, of perfecting their education in so many lines that it would be impossible for them to make use of all of them, is an injury rather than a benefit to the one who has so many advantages, besides depriving others of the privileges they need so much. If there were far less of this long-continued preparation, far less exclusive devotion to study only, there would be much more opportunity for an increase of the student's faith in God. He who long devotes all his energies to his studies alone becomes fascinated, is actually absorbed in his books, and loses sight of the goal for which he started when he came to school. It has been shown to me that some of the students are losing their spirituality, that their faith is becoming weak, and that they do not hold constant communion with God. They spend nearly all their time in the perusal of books. They seem to know but little else. But what advantage will all this preparation be to them? What benefit will they derive for all the time and money spent? I tell you, it will be worse than lost. There must be less of this kind of work and more faith in God's power. God's commandment, loving people, are to testify to the world of their faith by their works. Fundamentals of Christian Education, 336-337. In this closing work of the gospel, there is a vast field to be occupied, and more than ever before, the work is to enlist helpers from the common people. Both the youth and those older in years will be called from the field, from the vineyard, and from the workshop, and sent forth by the Master to give his message. Many of these may have had little opportunity for education, but Christ sees in them qualifications that will enable them to fulfill his purpose. If they put their hearts into the work and continue to be learners, he will fit them to labor for him. Welfare Ministry 108-109. Workers, gospel medical missionaries are needed now. You cannot afford to spend years in preparation. Soon doors now open to the truth will be forever closed. Carry the message now. Do not wait, allowing the enemy to take possession of the fields now open before you. Let little companies go forth to do the work to which Christ appointed his disciples. Let them labor as evangelists, scattering our publications and talking of the truth to those they meet. Let them pray for the sick, ministering to their necessities, not with drugs, but with nature's remedies, and teaching them how to regain health and avoid disease. Counsels on Health 397. Let them endeavor to treat the sick as they have opportunity, putting into practice the theory that they gain from the study of books. I have been instructed that in many instances, more practical knowledge can be obtained in this way than by a long course of study in a medical school. Medical Ministry 84. For additional study, Fundamentals of Christian Education 334 to 367, Speedy Preparation for the Work, 3 Testimonies 323 to 324, 5 Testimonies 22, Counsels on Health 395, Counsels to Parents, Teachers, and Students 404 to 419. This has been a production of Moisture by Sandia, promoting heavenly moisture with natural products, and GLAM, Global Anointing Movement, reawakening our need of the Holy Spirit to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ with power. Visit us at www.moisturebysandia.com to learn more.